Rochelle Tear from Ara Fine Arts, and welcome to episode 5 of my painting tutorials. In today's video, we will be painting a hibiscus. Let's get started. Start with a blank sheet of paper. Then, draw two curved lines in this area here. Like this. One curved line. Then another curved line. Next, draw a small half circle in this area. Then, draw another half circle around the small half circle, like this. Now draw a large circle to map out how large your hibiscus will be. Like this. Time to draw the petals. First, make two curved lines from your center half circles, like this. Very good. Now draw your petals using the outer circle as your guide. To draw your petals, make curvy lines with your pencil, like this. Very good. Let's do the second petal. Making the same curvy lines, draw your second petal. Your petals can take any shape you want them to. Just have fun! Great job so far. Keep going. Now that the petals are finished, we're going to draw the pistil and the stigma of the hibiscus. First, draw two small, short lines, like this. Then draw two curved lines, like I'm showing here, to draw the pistil, like this. Next, we're going to draw the stigma in this area here. To draw the stigma, you need two shapes, a triangle and a rectangle. First, draw the triangle, like this. Then draw the rectangle with two diagonal lines, like this. Next, we're going to add some leaves in the top right-hand corner of our paper, in this area. To draw your leaves, first make one curved line, like this. Then go to the top of that line and draw another curved line. Very good. You can draw as many leaves as you want to. Remember, draw a curved line, then go to the top of that line and draw another curved line. Very good. Next, we're going to add two leaves around our hibiscus. One here and here. Very good. Take out your eraser and lightly erase any guidelines on your drawing so that these lines don't show in your painting. Now that our drawing is complete, it is time to paint. Take out your paints and brushes and let's get started. Take out a palette for your paints. If you don't have a palette, you can always use a paper plate. Next, you will need at least two or three paint brushes. Make sure you get a cup of water. You will also need tissue or a washcloth to wipe your brushes. Time to mix our paints. The colors I will be using today are the three primary colors, yellow, red, blue, and then white and black. Mix all of your colors before you start painting. For the hibiscus, you need plain yellow. You will also need pink, which is white and a little bit of red. You will need plain red. You will also need a darker pink. And you will need purple, which is blue and red mixed together. For the background color, mix white and a little bit of blue. For the leaves, you need two greens, a light green and a dark green. To mix green, you need yellow and blue. Pause the video and take your time to mix your colors. Begin by applying your light blue pre-mixed background color to your painting. Carefully paint around the hibiscus and the leaves. Rinse out your brush and take some of your pre-mixed light green paint and apply it to your leaves. Use straight brush strokes as you apply the paint. Like this. Allow this first coat of paint to dry and then apply a second coat of light green paint. Remember, use straight brush strokes to apply the paint. Good job. Time to paint the hibiscus. We are going to paint one petal at a time. First, take the plain red paint and carefully apply it to the petal. As you paint, follow the direction according to the shape of the petal, like this. Next, carefully apply your light pink paint around the edge of your first petal. Take a dry paintbrush and gently blend the two colors together, like this. While the first petal dries, begin to apply your paint to the second petal. This petal is slightly underneath the top petal, so we need to paint a shadow. Use your purple pre-mixed paint for the shadow, like this. Continue to add some shadow along the edge of your petal, like this. Then take out your pre-mixed pink paint and begin to apply it to the edge of your petal and then the inside of your petal, like this. Using your dry brush, gently blend the colors together. For the remaining white area on your petal, take some of your pre-mixed light pink paint and begin to apply it, like this. Continue to paint the rest of the petals. Remember, take some of your plain red paint and begin to apply it. Then, take some of your pre-mixed pink paint and apply it near to the inside of the petal. Finally, apply your lightest pink paint to the petal, like this. Don't forget, take a dry paintbrush and gently blend the colors together. Great job! Continue to paint the other petals. Very good. Now allow this first coat of paint to dry, and then we will continue by adding more details to the hibiscus. Apply a second coat of plain red paint. Then, take some of your pre-mixed purple paint and apply it to the center of the hibiscus. Use this same pre-mixed purple paint around the edges of your hibiscus to add shadows and to give the hibiscus dimension, like this. Blend the paint nicely in. Next, take your pre-mixed light pink paint and begin to apply it to the hibiscus, like this. Don't forget to blend it in. Great job! Excellent! Mix white paint with a little bit of yellow and use this like I am for the details on the hibiscus. Make sure you use straight brush strokes as you apply your details. Great job! Next, using some of your pre-mixed pink paint, paint the pistil and the stigma of the hibiscus. Next, take some yellow paint and using your smallest brush, gently dab the paint on to create a dot effect, like this. Good job! Rinse out your brush and then add a second coat of green paint to your leaves. Now that you're finished, take some of the white and yellow paint, use straight brush strokes, and apply highlights onto the leaves, like this. Make sure you add highlights to the hibiscus. Great job! Sign your name in the right-hand corner of your painting. Wonderful! Excellent job! Thank you for watching my painting tutorial. I hope you had a wonderful time. Don't forget, post your image on Instagram and tag me at @arafineArts so that I can see your lovely creations. Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more art videos. Until next time, bye!